Hi friends, welcome back to the new series JavaScript 0 to Hero. In this series, I'm explaining all the basic concepts in JavaScript. In this video, I'm going to talk about strings in JavaScript. JavaScript string is a primitive data type that is used to store and manipulate texts. A JavaScript string is zero or more characters written inside quotes. Let me show you an example. We can use single quote or double quotes. But assume I want to wrap this with double quotes. Now it will not work. To fix this, we can use a backslash to escape this double quote and this one too. Now it will work. Another method is I can use single quote to wrap the entire text and use double quotes to wrap this. This will also work. Similarly, if you want to wrap some text with single quote, you can wrap the entire text with double quotes and wrap the particular text with single quote. And we can also create a string using the new keyword. When we create it using a new keyword, it is going to be a string object instead of primitive. But it is not recommended to create a string using new keyword. Now let's see some of the useful inbuilt functions and properties in string. Let me create a string. To get the first character, I can use channel name, square bracket, and zero. There is also an inbuilt function charAt. Let me use that now. Channel name dot charAt 3. This gives t. Please note the index always starts from 0. And we can use the length property to find the length of a string, like this. To convert a string to lowercase, we can use to lowercase. And to convert to uppercase, we can use to uppercase. We have already seen the plus operator will behave like a concatenation operator when there is a string. Let me create two strings. So we can use first string plus second string to see it is concatenated to hello world. But we have an inbuilt function also, concat. So instead of using plus operator, I can use first string dot concat second string. This will also give the same result. To find whether a particular string is present inside another string, we can use index of or includes. Index of gives the exact position. If there is no match, it returns minus 1. But includes returns either true or false. And we can use the split method to split the string. It will convert the entire string into an array. If I give a quote with space, we can see each word is now each item in the array. And if I give quotes without space, we can see each letter is now each item in the array. Assume we have a string animal equal to cat. Now I want to change it to rat. When I use animal square bracket 0, it gives C. So you may think we can assign animal square bracket 0 equal to R, like this. But this won't work. When I print animal, it is going to be cat only. We have replace function for this type of use case, where I can give the old character in the first argument and the new character in the second argument. So we get rat. So the string cat is converted to rat. Now a question to you. What will happen if I print the animal? Will we get cat or rat? We will get cat only, because string is immutable. So if we are applying any function, it won't change the actual string. For example, using to lowercase, I can convert the string to lowercase. But the original string is not changed. So to change the original string, we need to do it like original string equal to original string dot function. Finally, let us also see three other methods. Those are useful to extract a part of a string. Slice, substring, substr. Let me create a string. First, let's use the slice method to extract from 3 to 5. In slice method, we can pass two parameters. first one is to tell the starting position, and second one is to tell the ending position. But one thing to note here is, we need to give the exact starting position. Here it is going to be 3. And we need to give the ending position plus 1. So here, to get up to 5, we need to give the position as 5 plus 1, which is equal to 6. So we get 3, 4, 5. If we ignore the second parameter and give only the starting position, we get the string from 3 to end. If we ignore both the parameters, we get the same. And in slice method, we can also give negative values. So if I give myString.slice of minus 3, we get the last 3 characters. If I give myString of minus 5, comma minus 3, we get 56. If there is no match, we get empty string. Next one is substring. Substring method is similar to slice, but it cannot accept negative values. If I give 3, 8, we get 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If I give 3 alone, we get 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If I didn't give any value, we get the entire string. But if I give negative values, it will not work. And the last one is SUBSTR. This is also similar to slice, but here the second parameter specifies the length of the extracted part. So here, if I want to extract 3, 4, 5, we need to give the first position as 3 and the length of the character as 3. If I give 4, we get 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also, when I give only the first position, it extracts from starting position to the end of the string. If I didn't give any, then it will give the entire string. Here we can give negative values. To extract the last two characters, I can give myString.substring of minus 2. There are many other inbuilt functions available. I have explained only the functions we often use. That's all about strings in JavaScript. If you like this video, please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.